Hello everyone, I am Namita TN, Assistant Professor, Jyothi Engineering College, and in this session we are discussing the intermediate COCOMO. And what is this COCOMO? It is constructive cost model, and that one is developed by Barry Boehm. And the COCOMO is used to estimate the project attributes. And which are project attributes we are estimating? We are estimating the cost, we are estimating the effort and duration based on the estimated size of the software. And COCOMO is based on the hierarchy of three models. That is, three levels of COCOMO is there. We are starting with the basic COCOMO, and the next level is the intermediate level, and the next level is advanced model or detailed model. And in this session we are discussing the intermediate COCOMO, and we already discussed the basic COCOMO. And what is the difference between this basic COCOMO and the intermediate COCOMO? Actually, in basic COCOMO, that one will give a rough and quick estimate, and the accuracy is also very low. And it is because of this reason, in basic COCOMO, we are just considering whether the project is of type organic, semi-detached or embedded. Based on the size or based on the complexity, we are categorizing the project to three different levels, like organic project, semi-detached project and embedded project. And based on this thing alone, we are estimating the project attributes. But in the intermediate COCOMO, Boehm introduced an additional set of 15 cost drivers to take account of the software development. And hence, it will increase the accuracy of the estimate. And another difference is, in basic model, to estimate the effort, we are using the mathematical equation A into kilolines of code raised to B, where KLOC is the already estimated size of a project. And the duration, the equation for calculating the duration is C into effort raised to D. And where E is the effort, that one is applied in person months, and D is the development time in months. And in intermediate COCOMO, to estimate the effort, we are using the mathematical equation EI into EAF, where EI is the initial effort and EAF is the effort adjustment factor. And the initial effort, and that one is estimated using the same equation as that of basic model, and that one is the initial estimate EI, that one is equal to A into kilolines of code raised to B, where kilolines of code, that is the already estimated size. And what is this ABCD constants ABCD, and they are derived from the historical data of the organization. So since these constants depend on the local development environment, so these models are not transportable to different organization. In one organization, we are using the ABCD values like this, and in some other organizations, the value may be different. Okay, so as a reference, we are using this particular chart, and in this model, if the project is categorized as an organic project, the ABCD values will be 3.2, 1.05, 2.5 and 0.38. And if it is an embedded project, the value will be 2.8, 1.20, 2.5 and 0.32. So, in intermediate COCOMO also, first we need to identify our project is of type organic or embedded or semi-detached. That's the first step. And in what's the difference between this basic COCOMO and the intermediate COCOMO? In intermediate COCOMO, we are considering 15 cost drivers also. 15 more cost drivers. And the cost drivers are these ones. First one related with the product attributes, and the cost drivers are the required software reliability and the size of application database. Okay. And the next cost driver, that is related with the hardware attributes or computer attributes. And one example is the memory constraint. And the next cost driver attribute is personal attribute. And one example is analyst capability. And another cost driver related with the project attribute. And the cost drivers are user software rules, the required development schedule. All these ones are the 15 different cost drivers. And based on the ratings, that some ratings are also given, and the values will ranges from very low to extra high. That is, if our software reliability, if this one is stated, the software reliability is very low, that one will be stated in SRS document or some somewhere else, then if it is stated the software reliability is very low, then the rating will be 0.75. Okay, so these are the multiplying factors that we will discuss later to find the effort adjustment factor. So here, if it is stated the memory constraint is high, then the value associated with this cost driver, that one will be 1.06. And in this way the organization will form a cost driver chart also. And in intermediate model, the 15 parameters like software reliability and software complexity are also considered along with the size while estimating the effort. Actually, we are estimating the project attributes like effort, development time, the cost, the staff size, all these project attributes we are estimating. And first we are estimating the effort, and that one will be with the help of this equation, that is effort equal to the total effort is effort adjustment factor into EI, where EI is the initial effort. So this is the equation where EI is A into kilo lines of code raised to B, and these AB values, that one will be, we will get those values from the historical term. So these are the ABCD values. If the project is organic, the values will be as per the first row. And if the project is of type embedded, the ABCD values will be 2.8, 1.20, 2.5 and 0.32. Okay. So how to estimate? Here we are estimating the project attribute effort. Then based on effort, we can calculate the development time. Once we calculated or estimated the effort, then the duration will be C into effort raised to D, and those C and D values we will get from the historical data and the effort that we already estimated the effort. Then how to estimate this effort? So the total effort is the we need to estimate the effort. Then the total effort is initial effort EI into effort adjustment factor. So first we need to estimate the or calculate the initial effort, and the second step we are identifying a set of 15 parameters which are derived from the attributes of the current project, and all these parameters are rated against the numeric value, and that one will be given in that table. If the reliability is very low, then we are taking the multiplying factor associated with that cost driver value. And the effort adjustment factor is derived by multiplying all the multiplying factors with each other. Then once the EAF is calculated, that is the effort adjustment factor is calculated, then we are finding the total effort by multiplying the initial effort with the effort adjustment factor. So now we are moving to the problem part, and in this example, we need to estimate the total effort. So our question is, a project whose size is 45 kilo lines of code is considered and some cost driver attributes are also given. Estimate the total effort in this model, and the cost drivers are the reliability is high, the complexity is low, the application experience is high, and the programmer capability is nominal. So this is the question. We need to estimate the total effort, and the project size is estimated as 45 kilo lines of code, and some cost driver attributes are also given as per this table. So the first step to estimate the effort is, first we are calculating the initial effort. Initial effort. Why we are calculating that initial effort? Because our total effort, that is equal to initial effort into effort adjustment factor. Then the initial effort, we will get that one with the help of the previous equation. As per the basic COCOMO model, the effort is A into kilo lines of code raised to B. And in the same manner, here also we are estimating the initial effort using the same equation, A into kilo lines of code raised to B. And our project is of which category? Since the size estimated is 45 kilo lines of code, definitely we should categorize our project to an organic project. Organic project, its size is less than 50 kilo lines of code. Okay, and from that statement, the size estimated is 45 kilo lines of code, and from that statement we can categorize our project to an organic project. So the initial effort is A into kilolengths of code raised to B, and we are taking that ABCD values as per the organic project. Okay, that is the values are 3.2, 1.05, 2.5 and 0.38. So the initial effort is calculated as A into kilolengths of code raised to B, that is 3.2 into what is KLOC? That is the estimated size. Here the estimated size is 45 raised to 1.05. And that one is equal to 174 person months. Okay. So where EA is the initial effort, and that here we are using the same equation as that of basic COCOMO. And next we are estimating, or next we are calculating the effort adjustment factor. Why we are calculating that effort adjustment factor? Because as per intermediate COCOMO, the total effort is initial effort into effort adjustment factor. And in our example, the some cost driver attributes are also given, that is reliability is high, and the cost driver attribute, the multiplying factor related with the reliability is high, so the value associated with the required software reliability, that one is 1.15, and the complexity is low. So the cost driver and the multiplying factor, complexity is low, so the value is 0.85. The multiplying factor associated with this particular cost driver is 0.85. And another cost driver attribute is also given, that is the application experience is high. So as per the application experience, it is high. So the multiplying factor is 0.91. And we will get all these values from this table itself. So the effort adjustment factor is derived by multiplying all the multiplying factors with each other, that is the cost driver and its related multiplying factors will be multiplied with each other, and in this way we are multiplying 1.15, 0.85, 0.91 and 1. So and all the other cost driver attributes, we are considering them as nominal and the value is 1. So we will get the effort adjustment factor as 0.885. So once the EAF is calculated, then the effort estimate for a software project is obtained by multiplying the effort adjustment factor with the initial estimate EI. So total effort equal to initial effort into effort adjustment factor, that is initial effort that is already estimated and it is 174, and the effort adjustment factor, that one is 0.8895. So our total effort is 155 person months, that is the total effort estimated as per intermediate COCOMO. Okay, thank you.